Only a trained and licensed electrician should perform the wiring and connections described in this video. Do not attempt an installation without first reading the manual and disconnecting power. With the battery modules installed and secured to the PWRcell battery cabinet, it's time to wire them and connect them to the battery management unit, or BMU. Locate the battery's power cable harness. It's built into the battery cabinet and runs down the right side of the cabinet alongside the battery modules. It includes touch-safe power connectors that connect all battery modules in a series circuit to the BMU for charging and discharging, along with Ethernet communication cables that allow the BMU to communicate with each battery module. Using the Ethernet cables in the power cable harness and the black Ethernet jumper cables found in the hardware kit, we will daisy chain all of the installed battery modules. Following the same order in which we installed the batteries, we will wire them from top to bottom, back to front. Starting with the topmost rear battery module, install the gray Ethernet-style cable to the COM in port. Then, on the topmost front battery, install the blue Ethernet-style cable to the COM out port. This leaves the COM out port on the rear battery and the COM in port on the front battery both open. This is where we'll install one of the black Ethernet jumper cables. The Ethernet jumper cables will always go from the COM out port on the rear battery to the COM in port on the front battery of any given shelf. Moving on to the middle shelf, connect the blue Ethernet-style cable to the rear battery's COM in port, then connect the orange Ethernet-style cable to the front battery's COM out port. Again, install a black Ethernet jumper cable between the back battery's COM out port and the front battery's COM in port. On the bottom shelf, connect the orange Ethernet-style cable to the rear battery's COM in port, but leave the front battery's COM out port open. Note that regardless of how many battery modules are part of your installation, nothing needs to be connected to the COM out port of the last module. Then, take the last Ethernet jumper cable and install it between the back battery's COM out port and the front battery's COM in port. With the communication cables connected, we can now install the power cables. If you have not already done so, remove the rubber stoppers from each installed module's power port. Now, connect each module to the power cable harness using the nearest plugs on the harness. A noticeable click indicates a good, solid connection. If your PWRcell battery configuration uses fewer than 6 modules, cap off the unused plugs using the included loop jumper cables. Note that the system will only function if every single plug on the power cable harness is connected to a battery module or a loop jumper cable. Double check your connections and please refer to the manual for any further questions.